Hi everyone. In this video, I want to explain electromagnetic induction. For this experiment, we only need one coil, which is connected to a voltmeter with power cables. We also need a bar magnet. If the bar magnet is approached to the coil, the pointer of the voltmeter deflects. However, as soon as the bar magnet stops moving, the deflection on the voltmeter will decrease. If you remove the bar magnet from the coil, the pointer of the voltmeter deflects again, but this time in the other direction. However, as soon as the bar magnet stops moving, the deflection on the voltage measuring device decreases again. In order to be able to explain this clearly, it is helpful to depict the magnetic field of the bar magnet. Usually, a magnetic field is represented using magnetic field lines. In this case, we represent the magnetic field in color. The darker the blue, the stronger the magnetic field. The magnetic field is strongest in the vicinity of the bar magnet and then decreases more and more with distance. If you move the magnet in the direction of the coil, the strength of the magnetic field changes that passes through the coil. When the magnetic field strength changes, a voltage is induced in the coil. Only when the bar magnet is no longer moved does the magnetic field strength that passes through the coil remain constant. The consequence of this is that no more voltage is induced in the coil. A voltage is only induced again when the strength of the magnetic field that passes through the coil changes. But why does the pointer of the voltmeter move first in one direction and then in the other? To explain this clearly, let's look at the movement of some free electrons in the coil and in the power cables. First of all, the electrons are evenly distributed. If you now approach the bar magnet to the coil, the electrons in the coil flow in a certain direction. As a result, there are more free electrons at the end of the right power cable, which is connected to the voltmeter, than at the end of the left power cable. In this case, the pointer points to the right. As soon as the bar magnet is no longer moved, all free electrons are distributed evenly again. If the bar magnet is removed from the coil, the free electrons in the coil flow in the opposite direction. Now there are more free electrons at the end of the left power cable. In this case, the pointer of the voltmeter points to the left. Only when the bar magnet stops moving will the free electrons be evenly distributed again.